New Zealand need one. Oh, Massey's out. If he hits, he's out. They strike. Oh, double play. Upstairs we go. Do New Zealand win?
New Zealand needed one run in the last ball of this test match. And this one run will not decide their team chances to reach the WTC finals. Rather, it will decide the fate of the Indian team to reach the World Test Championship final. Australia have already cemented the place in the finals when this ball was bowled, after beating India in the third test of the Border Gavaskar Trophy earlier this month. So it was between Sri Lanka or India to grab the second spot, as South Africa was already out of contention after losing the series to Australia. And this last ball will decide who will play Australia for the title at the Oval in London from June 7th. But how did this happen, that the Indian team, who have been playing and competing for more than 2 years to secure the spot in the finals, have to rely on this one final ball of the match from the same team that defeated India in their inaugural WTC finals? Let's go down a little in time to figure this out. Hello and welcome everyone to Sports 99 Info presenting India's Road to WTC Finals. India's journey in the second cycle of WTC began with a test series in England in August-September 21 under the Kohli Shastri regime. When it came to home, India were an absolute force to deal with. But India's overseas performance were not as dominant as when they play at home. The Kohli Shastri era redefined Indian test cricket, and they have built a solid bowling attack which can take 20 wickets in away conditions as well. The first test between India and England went into a draw, as most of the test match was affected due to rain and there wasn't enough play to decide a winner. Only positive to take out from this test was Ravindra Jadeja, who became only the fifth cricketer for India to score 2000 runs and take 200 wickets in tests. Second test saw some unbelievable and historic moments in Indian test cricket history, and will be remembered for a long time. The main highlight of this match was the Bumrah-Shami partnership, where they put on an unbeaten strand of 89 runs against the pace attack of Anderson, Robinson and Marksman. And provided India with a chance of winning the match. India had only 60 overs to knock the oppositions out. And guess what? The Indian pace attack, developed under Kohli Shastri, did it with more than 8 overs to spare. And India won by 151 runs. KL Rahul, for his brilliant 129 runs, was awarded Man of the Match. Only for the second time in Indian Test cricket history, spinners haven't taken a wicket for India in consecutive tests. Such was the dominance of Indian pace attack under Kohli Shastri. But do you know about the first instance where this happened? Let me know in the comment section. Small hint, it was when great Sachin Tendulkar debuted in tests. With the second test win, India went on to the third test with a lot of confidence on their backs, but England came back more stronger. Indian batting fell like pack of cards, and England won by an innings and 76 runs, backed by some fiery bowling spell from Anderson, Robinson and Overton. Come the fourth test and India were not looking good. Not many expected India to bounce back in such an emphatic manner after they were trailing by 99 runs at the halfway stage. But Rohit Sharma's brilliance and Shardul Thakur's contributions came to India's rescue. And finally, India won by 157 runs. It was a great team effort by India to go up 2-1 in the series. But Shardul's KMU in the first innings of 57 runs of just 36 balls made it possible for an Indian win. The fifth and final test match was unfortunately cancelled due to rising COVID cases in the Indian camp. The fifth test was later scheduled to play when India visited England in July 2022. Lot happened when India visited England in July 2022 to play the fifth and final test. Next came New Zealand tour of India. India played a two-match home series against New Zealand. Rahul Dravid had graduated up to take the spot left vacant by Ravi Shastri. Although the first test match played at Kanpur resulted in a draw, but we saw a new Indian star debuting in test cricket for India. Shreyas Iyer, debuted in this match and scored his maiden 100. India wanted a win, not a draw, not on their home conditions, to keep up with the WTC points table. And as it happened, they won the second test at Mumbai by a whopping 372 runs. India's biggest win in test in terms of runs. Thanks to the brilliant knock from Mayank Agarwal, who scored 150 and 62 and bagged Man of the Match award for this match. India finished the series 1-0. But we witnessed a very unique record in this test, where we saw Azhar Patel, playing for New Zealand, go on to become only the third bowler in history of test cricket to take 10 wickets in an innings after Jim Lakeer and Anil Kumble. Next came the tour of South Africa. India have done well in England, where they have leading 2-1 and wanted to reproduce the same in South Africa. And they did it so in the first match at Centurion by winning the match by 113 runs. KL Rahul continued his good away form and produced a match-winning innings of 123 runs. Rishabh Pant became the fastest wicketkeeper for India in terms of innings to effect 100 dismissals in tests. In the same test, Mohammad Shami took 8 wickets in the match and completed his 200 wickets in tests. India started the year with a win at the Gabba, ending it with one at the Centurion. This Indian team stamped their mark all over the world, where the bowling attack produced wins in away matches. But India couldn't keep up the same level of performance and lost to South Africa by 7 wickets in the second test. KL Rahul captained India in tests for the first time in absence of Kohli. Although India lost the match, one notable performance from Indian side in the match was Shardul Thakur, who took his first 5 wicket haul in tests. He ended with figures of 7 for 61. Third test also didn't go in India's favour, as South Africa go on to win the match by 7 wickets again. It was a glorious opportunity lost by India to win the maiden test series in South Africa, a chance that's gone down the drain. India ended up losing series 1-2 to South Africa. A unique thing happened in this test. South African fielders took 20 catches in the match. Yes, you heard it right. The first time in Test cricket history that one team were dismissed twice by being caught. No run outs, no LBWs, no bowled. India's home series against Sri Lanka was Rohit Sharma's first as the permanent test captain. India won the first test convincingly by an innings and 222 runs. Ravindra Jadeja, for his 175 runs not out and 9 wickets in the match, bagged the Man of the Match award. Shreyas Iyer, 92 and 67, and Bumrah's 8 wickets helped India in the second test and registered a 2-0 series win against Sri Lanka at home. It was July 2022 and India toured England to play their 5th rescheduled match. By the time when this test started, England have already introduced Baz Ball in Test cricket under their new coach Brendan McCullum. And man, they were playing Test cricket with some authority. And they blew away Team India by chasing 378 runs on the 5th day against the dominant bowling attack of Bumrah, Shami, Siraj and Jadeja, and won the test by 7 wickets. Turning hundreds from Pant and Jadeja and an unbelievable world record set by Bumrah, hitting Stuart Broad for 35 runs in an over, all gone in vain. This match witnessed Bumrah captaining India for the first time in Test cricket, and the series was tied at 2-2. India then moved on to tour of Bangladesh. The first test was an easy win for India, thanks to some great batting for performance from the Indian batters and exceptional bowling by Kuldeep Yadav. The long drought of century was ended for Pujara, as he scored a blistering knock of 102 not out in just 130 balls, and could have made 200s in the same match, but unfortunately, he was out at a score of 90 in the first innings. Shubman Gill also made his maiden ton in Test cricket with a score of 110. But the man of the match was bagged by Kuldeep Yadav, who was making his comeback in Test cricket. He bowled brilliantly and took crucial wickets in the match. He clinched 8 wickets in the match. The second Test match was not as easy as the first. This was a proper thriller of a game where India was struggling at 74 for 7. Chasing down a small target of just 145 runs. It required the cricketing smarts and temperament of Ashwin Iyer partnership to bail the visitor out, and eventually winning the match by 3 wickets. The duo showed everyone exactly how to play on a turning surface. Ashwin record-breaking knock of 42 not out in the second inning and a bowling display of 4 for 71 and 2 for 66 bagged him the Man of the Match award. And thus, India brought down the curtains on 2022 with a 2-0 victory in Bangladesh and moved on to second position on WTC points table. One of the great motivational and inspirational moments from this test was the comeback of Jaydev Unadkat, who appeared in a test match after 12 years and 2 days. In between his 2 test appearances, he missed 118 tests, the most by any Indian player and second most by any player in the world. Let me know in the comment section who was the first to have achieved this feat. Then came the big Australia's tour of India. India began 2023 with an eye onto the WTC finals. They had to win the series 3-0, or better, to book a spot in the WTC finals. The endeavours with wins over Australia in Nagpur and Delhi, where the visitors surrender against spin. The first test saw a dominant performance by Indian unit as they won by an innings and 132 runs. Australia only managed 91 runs in the second innings to record their lowest total in India. KS Bharat and Surya Kumar Yadav earned their test debut with this match. The all-round performance by Jadeja, hitting 70 runs and claiming 7 wickets in the match, bagged him the Man of the Match award. His partner, Ashwin, also claimed a fifer and went on to become the second fastest bowler in terms of matches to take 450 wickets in just 89 tests. Rohit Sharma also made a big contribution of 120 runs in the first inning to help India see the victory. India continued their dominance in second test with the help of their spin trio of Ashwin, Jadeja and Akshar. India won the test convincingly by 6 wickets and retained the Border Gavaskar Trophy. Jadeja picked 10 wickets and showed the world why he is the best test all-rounder going around the world. In the same match, Virat Kohli became the fastest in terms of innings to complete 25,000 runs in international cricket. Third test was a little disappointing for Indians as the batting let down, and Australia managed to win the match by 9 wickets in just 3 days. This was Australia's first test win in India since 2017 and the first win by any visiting team in India since 2021. Such was the dominance of Indian team at home. The great spinner from Australia, Nathan Lyon, bring down hell on Indian batsmen as he took 11 wickets in the match and helped Australia qualify for the WTC finals. India, at this point, was left helpless and was at the second spot, but not by a good margin, and were either at the mercy of New Zealand to beat Sri Lanka or beat Australia in the last match of the series. Sri Lankans, who were ranked third in the WTC points table, needed to win both the test against the Black Caps to book their tickets to the finals. So, fourth test match started with a lot of hopes and expectations. India were playing Australia at Narendra Modi Stadium in Ahmedabad, and Sri Lanka started their series against New Zealand in Christchurch, with the hope of winning the first and eventually second match to secure the spot in WTC finals. India didn't got the start they wanted, as the Australian batsmen showed their composure and toughness against the good bowling attack of India. Khwaja and Green showed their great temperament and brought their hundreds as they posted 480 in the first innings. India's replies was as good, as Kohli and Subman Gill also showed their class and scored hundreds and helped India post a total of 571 runs. But although there was a great batting display from both sides, the test was heading towards a draw. Contrary to India and Australia match, which was looking like a dead rubber, Sri Lanka and New Zealand match was producing a thrilling contest, where New Zealand required to chase 257 of just 53 overs, and it wasn't an easy task. The match went down to the last ball, when New Zealand needed one run in one ball, and thus, this last ball decided the fate of India's chance of playing WTC finals against Australia on June 7 at the Oval in London. Thanks to brilliant knock by Williamson, who held his nerves and managed to cross the victory and hand over India the second consecutive final in the World Test Championship 2023. It was a roller coaster journey for Team India, but they are in the finals. Hope you liked and enjoyed watching India's road to WTC finals. Please like and subscribe to the channel for more such contents in future. Till then, goodbye.